Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad, and welcome to file handling tutorials on C programming language. Now, in this video, we will talk about how we can read a character from the file using the fgetc function. In the previous tutorials, we have seen what are files, how we can create them, how we can write characters to the file. In this video, we will talk about how we can read characters from the file. Now, here, the function that we are talking about is called as the fgetc. Now, if we look at the syntax of this particular function, the name of the function is fgetc, get a character from the file. We have to provide the file pointer as the argument, and it returns an integer value. And what this function does is it reads single character at a time from the file, and it returns that. If we look at the return value, the type is integer. The reason for that is in C language, characters are represented using the numeric codes depending on the encoding standard. So whatever the character is read from the file, the numeric code of that character will be returned. Now, when there are no characters to read from the file, when we read the end of the file, it returns the character code equivalent of EOF, you know, which is the end of file character, which will denote that that's the end of the file. So here, let us see how we can use this in our program and how we can read the characters from the file. So here, what I have done is I have already written some code. In this folder where I have this source code, I also have a file called as input.txt. This file contains this text. And what I want to do is, I want to use this fgetc function and read those characters from the file, and I want to display them on the screen. So here, what I have done is, I have opened the file using the file opening mode R, that is for reading purpose. Then I have checked whether we have successfully opened the file or not. If there is any error, we are displaying this error message. If the file has been opened successfully, then we can read from the file. So here, what I will do is I will define a variable, and it will be of type integer. I will call it as ch, and in this variable, I will store a value of 0. What I want to do is I want to use the fgetc function. Whatever the character code that I get from that function, I want to store that in this ch variable. Or maybe I can say ch code, character code. And here I'm storing the value of 0. If I want, I can specify the string termination character also, which is denoted by this backslash 0. The numeric equivalent code is 0. If I take the cursor here, then you guys can see. So here we will use the fgetc function. So it will be fgetc. And we just have to specify the file pointer, which is present in this fp. And this will return a character. We will store that in this character code variable. So now what I will do is I will use the printf function, and I will display percentage %d, then colon percentage %c. I want to display the numeric code, and also I want to display the specific character. So it will be ch underscore code, and again ch underscore code, which is the name of the variable. Now here, I'm gonna save this program, and I will run this. Now, if everything works out, then we will get the value as 83 and yes here. The reason for that is in this input.txt file, the first character that we have is capital S. The 83 is the numeric code according to the encoding standard used for that character S. So that has been displayed here. Now, what if this file contains nothing? So I'm gonna remove the contents here from this input.txt. I will go back to the program and I will run this now. And this time we will get -1. And this value -1 is called as the end of file character, which is used to denote that that's the end of the file. I will come back to the input.txt and I will restore the contents. Now I will come back to the fgetc function. Now here, if you keep on calling it multiple times, something like this, you know, In the first call, it will get the first character. Then in the second call, it will get the next character. Just to denote that, I will insert a new line in the first printf statement. And then I will run this program again. So here we will see 83 and then 117, that is for yes and you. If we look at the input.txt, these are the first two characters. Why we get only two characters here? That's because we have called this function twice. Now the next thing is how we can read all the contents, all the text of this file using this fgetc function. What we can do is we can use a loop. So here I will use the while loop. And in the condition part of this while loop, what we do is first read the character from the file. So it will be character code equal to fgetc function and the file pointer. And we will check whether it is equal to end of file character minus one, you know, which is represented by this EOF. If I take the cursor on that, you guys can see it expands to minus one. So as long as the character that we are reading from the file is not the end of file character, we want to keep on running this while loop. And in this while loop, in the body of this while loop, what we want to do, we just want to display the character that we have read from the file. So just like this. Now, if I save this program and if I run this, here you guys can see we get subscribe if you like the video. That is the content that we have in this input.txt. We can also see the numeric code here. Now we will make it pretty. We will get rid of this numeric code part and we will not insert the new line character. We will just display the character. Now, if I save this program and if I run this now, you guys can see subscribe if you like the video. If I open up the input.txt, you guys can see the content. Now, what if I add some lines here and then I will have some other text in here? What happens now? I will come back to the source code. I will run it again. And again, as we have seen, all the contents of the file is displayed here. So what we have done here is we have learned how we can use the fgetc function, how we can read single character from the file, and how we can display that on the screen. We have also seen how we can use a loop and read all the characters from the file. So this is it guys for this particular video. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials, subscribe to the channel.